Collect lots of loot every day by completing these 5 simple routines and you will be on your way to becoming even stronger. Sooner or later, you will run into the problem of not having enough materials to ascend your characters or weapons. You can easily prepare for this by hunting down all the elite monsters during the day. All of these elite monsters can only be hunted for a limited number of times before they go on a long cooldown that can be up to for 14 hours or more. You can also acquire these materials from the in-game shop by using Star Glitter that you can get from Wishing, but it's far more reasonable to first get the free monthly fates. What's also interesting is that an upgraded version of this material will start dropping when you increase your world level. One cool thing that you can do with all the lesser materials you've acquired is convert them into the upgraded ones by using the alchemy table. Make sure to check if any of your characters using the alchemy table can give further bonuses. For example, Sucrose can randomly double the amount of materials you would obtain. This way, even if you end up with more materials than you need, you can always convert them into better ones, and hunting for these elite monsters will always have an excellent payoff. Another great way to make passive income of awesome loot is by doing the expeditions. Now, while this is an obvious thing to do, what's a little more deceiving are the items various expeditions provide. It's almost always the best choice to simply send characters to gather more crystal ores. If you don't want to bother with reassigning characters too often, you can simply send them out for the longest 20-hour expedition. The amount of expeditions you can go on will just keep increasing once you're further in the game, and so will the choices. It's still a good idea to just send everyone out to gather more crystal ores, while at the same time, for any leftover expeditions, you just gather materials such as lotus heads, which can be prepared for tasty dishes like jade parcels. Sometimes the best loot isn't the most exciting, but it sure gets more interesting once you add scarcity to it. Every region has their own special items, such as Juyin chilies in Liyue region or wolf hooks in Mondstadt, and once you pick them up, they only reappear after a day or two passes in real time. You will need these materials to keep ascending your character levels, and the required quantity of them will only keep increasing. To make sure you're not missing out on them, mark the locations you visit by clicking on the map, which also allows you to edit the name of the marker. You can then go out every day and check these markers to see if any of these specialties have respawned. Another awesome thing about these specialties is that you need to acquire 100 of them from each region to complete the 2 weekly battle pass missions. So not only will you have an easier time ascending your characters, but it will also work towards completing your battle pass for some generous rewards. You would think that killing giant dragons gives the most useful loot, but what you're really going to be doing is raiding innocent shop owners instead. If you still haven't noticed, every shop has a timer that shows when the stock will refresh, and making this as one of your everyday tasks to visit them can bring a lot of loot, provided you have enough mora. A good number of these shops are secret and don't show up on the map as an icon, so you need to find these sellers yourself. For example, there's a shop in each major city that sells 2-star artifacts. You can easily purchase them to use as enhancement material for your main artifacts. You can also talk to the bartender in the Mondstadt Tavern, where you can purchase useful enhancement food like wolf hook juice. And let's not forget the guy in Liyue City who sells ores, and one of them is the Noctilucas ore, which is needed for Beidou's ascension. Finally, there's 2 flower girls you can visit. One is Flora, who is found in Mondstadt City, and the other one is Chloris, which can be found wandering on the main road above Windrise. Most of these shops share the timer for when they reset their stock, so it's a good idea to keep this in mind when you're planning your return trips. The last few things to keep in mind are the daily commissions and weekly boss fights. Both of these provide a steady supply of loot and adventure rank experience. You should always make sure to complete your daily commissions, as some of them can award you with new recipes and other unique things. As for the weekly bosses, both of them can be unlocked by progressing naturally through the story, and you'll be able to fight Dwalin at rank 25, while the Giant Wolf can be done as early as rank 21. To summarize, you can get a lot of loot not just by exploring the world and completing quests, but also by following some simple routines as well. Clearing out the limited amount of elite monsters each day will award you with ascension materials that can also be further upgraded at the alchemy table. If you want a passive stream of crystal ores, just simply send out characters on expeditions. And if you're in the mood for some walking, you can patrol the areas where you mark the location of each local specialty. Finally, there are many shops shops you can revisit each time their stock refreshes. Getting more artifacts, flowers for ascension, or even ores will help you out in the long run as long as you keep revisiting them. Enjoyed the video? Make sure to subscribe to our channel, hit the bell icon, and gently press the like button. Don't forget to check out our other Genshin Impact guides, which also includes a tier list that you can also visit on our website gachagamer.com. Thank you for watching us.